dispatch has this moment arrived from the Malabar front. Our forces in South India have won a glorious victory. Thousands of the enemy have been annihilated. The actions we are now reporting may well bring the war within its measurable distance of its glorious end. All hail, Big Brother.
Good morning, comrade.
Ah, yes, Comrade Parsons. Good morning.
And how is the news this morning?
The usual. Another victory for our army in India.
Then the war should be over soon. That's good. Very good. Strength are long enough now.
Attention, comrades. This morning, three spies confessed to being members of the Goldstein Brotherhood of Traitors. This afternoon, at 1700 hours, they will be hanged in Victory Square. All party members are invited to attend. Here is more glorious news. We have won the battle for production. The Ministry of Plenty has announced the overproduction of shoes by 483,961,202 pairs in the second half of the sixth third year plan. Our standard of living has risen 20% over the past year. All over Oceania, workers are parading through the streets of Thanos, voicing their gratitude to Big Brother for the new, happy life, which his wise leadership has bestowed upon us. All hail, Big Brother. All love, Big Brother.
A little late this morning, aren't you, comrade?
They haven't got this morning's workaround yet.
You missed the morning newscast. I should report you.
What is the news, Parsons?
Well, as I was coming in, they were announcing still another victory. I'm not sure just where.
So, you were late too?
Of course I was here. I heard the news, all of it. Good morning, comrades. Big Brother has plenty for you to do today. Comrade Syme, this is for you. You're ordered to have it translated into Newspeak no later than 1230 hours. Comrade Parsons, nothing for you.
Nothing? I don't understand.
You're ordered to report to the Bureau of Hate. You have been reassigned.
Reassigned? But why?
Ignorance is strength, comrade. Don't ask me why. Ask the Thought Police. Have you been making mistakes? Have you been indulging in crime?
No. Certainly not. That's a terrible suggestion. Bureau of Hate. It must be a promotion. That's it, Smith. Isn't it time to be promoted?
I wouldn't know.
They couldn't reassign someone who failed them. Why, there isn't a more devoted party member than I in all of London.
Just be there by 930. They'll be expecting. Comrade Smith, this is for you. A whole month's worth of mail reports from the Times.
Thank you. Wait! What about Withers? You forgot him.
Withers? I have nothing here for any Withers.
This desk right here. The man who's been working with us for the past month. Bob Withers.
There's no such name on my route list. Good morning, comrades.
Did you know about this Parsons?
Yes.
But what?
Let's not talk about it, all right? He's not here. That's all we need to know.
Then he was...
Yes.
Attention. Attention all comrades under the age of 60. Calisthenics. Out of your seats and onto your feet. Calisthenics. Good morning, comrades. First, we'll start with our deep breathing exercises. Hands raised slowly over your head as you inhale. Lower them slowly as you exhale. Now, by the numbers. 1, 2, 1, 2, keep it up, 1, 2, there, doesn't that make you feel better, 1, 2, oh it's good to breathe the fine clean air of Oceania, 1, 2, 1, 2, Not like the old days, is it, comrades? Before the revolution, children went to work in factories. Men died of tuberculosis before they were 30. Keep it up, comrades. One, two, all rest. Our exercise period is to be cut short this morning. We have to be ready for the 2 minute heat. All ready? Last exercise. Hands on hips. Touch your toes with the fingertips and engage them lazily. All ready? One, two. Down, up, down, up. Don't bend those knees. One, two. You, Smith, number 6079, Comrade Winston Smith. You can do better than that. Your hands are better than your knees. You're not trying. Now, for Oceania, for Big Brother, Smith, make it yellow. 1, 2, let's see you do it. 1, 2, that's better. All right, that'll be all for this morning. Back to you, Will. See you tomorrow.
Are you all right?
Of course I'm all right.
You look pale.
I'm naturally pale.
I just thought...
Well, don't! It's time to get back to work anyway.
Have you heard about the 2 minute heat this morning? I'm told it's something special.
Something plus good. Double plus good.
It's always something special.
We need something special.
It keeps us interested in the war.
That's right, Smith. You don't have the privilege of fighting on the front lines. We must fight the best we can here at home.
What is the heat today?
I hear it's going to be Goldstein himself. Isn't that exciting?
Double plus exciting.
I can hardly wait. Well, drink up. Next coffee period at 1100 hours, comrades. Get your hoop going, please.
Worse every day. I can hardly drink it.
That bridge is on quite thick, comrade. Really, it is quite good. I always feel much better after my regular coffee. Calm, you know, the more at ease about things.
What would they put in this stuff? I say, Smith, do you know what they put in our coffee?
I wouldn't know. I never drink it anyway.
Whatever it is, sure it isn't coffee.
You're finding fault with Big Brother. That's quite thick. I better report you to the thought police.
Attention! Attention, board member and her party.
This is Comrade O'Brien. He is Smith, sir. That one. Number 6079.
Thank you. Turn the screen down. Do you mean to turn it off? Of course not. Just turn the volume down. Yes, sir. I don't want any interruptions. You must remember that although you cannot hear it, and can only see the picture of Big Brother, it can still both see and hear you. Many thought criminals have been trapped by it. Comrade Smith, I would like to talk to you.
Of course, Comrade O'Brien. I'll see that it doesn't happen again. I wasn't very late, only a few seconds, really.
Never mind that now. There are more important things than labels. I would like to be alone with Comrade Smith. Comrade Smith, I was recently reading one of your Newspeak articles in the Times. You take a scholarly interest in Newspeak?
I'm more of an amateur. It's not my subject. Simon's the expert. I've never been involved with the actual construction of the language.
You're too modest, Smith. You write it very elegantly. That is not only my own opinion. I was talking recently to a friend of yours. His name has slipped my memory for the moment, but no matter. This is Comrade Julia. She is to take the place of Bob. The vacant place next to you. You know each other, Smith?
No, Comrade O'Brien, I just didn't expect a woman.
She's young, but she's worked here at the Ministry of Truth for 3 years now, in the fiction department. We of the inner party have watched her work closely and believe she's capable of a more serious job.
Yes, of course, Comrade O'Brien.
Teacher, answer her questions. You are fully capable of that, Smith. More so than you realize, perhaps.
Yes, Comrade O'Brien. Thank you, Comrade O'Brien.
Good morning, comrades.
That will be your desk, comrade.
Thank you, comrade.
Why are you here, comrade?
Comrade O'Brien told you.
I heard him. He said their inner party thinks you are capable.
That must be why they reassigned me.
But why here? You aren't suitable for this job.
I'm a loyal party member.
That's not what I meant. I've seen you before, comrade.
And I've seen you. What of it? We both work in the same building.
But we don't live in the same building. I've seen you on the street outside my apartment. Why?
I'm not here to be cross-examined, comrade. I'm here to do a job.
I beg your pardon. I'll be glad to answer any questions, comrade.
Thank you. Whose place am I taking?
Bobbins. I mean no one's place. You are taking no one's place.
Who used to work here?
No one, I tell you. An unperson. Don't you understand an unperson?
Unperson? No. No, I don't understand.
Aren't you familiar with new speak at all?
A few words. Crank think, duck speak, good think. Many should I know means the Ministry of Truth. Pros means the workers, the proletariat. They aren't really human. Child hero means a child who's a member of the Children's Spies Organization, who has turned in a member of his own family for thought crime. But I've never heard of an unperson.
I'll ask Comrade Sun, the expert, to explain Newspeak to you. In the meantime, there is the latest edition of the Newspeak Dictionary. In it are all old-speak words, what we used to call standard English, translated into Newspeak.
But an unperson.
An unperson is a person who's been vaporized, hanged, killed. He no longer exists.
Vaporized, of course. But he did exist at one time.
No, he never existed. That's your job. Look here. This message. Time 17 slant 3 slant 82. Bob Withers mayor reported a ward rectifier.
What does that mean?
That in the March 17, 1982 edition of the London Times, Bob Withers was awarded the Good Worker. So we choose the name of another worker in the Ministry of Truth, any name, and send it to the Times for correction.
Then what happens?
Then that issue of the Times is rerun with the correction. All old editions are destroyed. Toss the message into the incinerator. Destroy it. Then there are no records at all that Bob Withers ever existed.
But you know he existed.
I do not know he existed.
But you just
comrade!
Said...
You know the word doublethink?
Yes.
You must use doublethink. All good, loyal party members are capable. I am capable. You must be capable.
But why change the records?
You know the party slogan. Who controls the past, controls the future. Who controls the present, controls the past.
I didn't know it had a meaning. I thought it just didn't mean anything. Like the other slogans. War is peace, freedom is slavery, ignorance is strength.
Of course it has a meaning. It's our job here in the Ministry of Truth to carry out that slogan. To control the past.
Attention, comrades. Attention for the 2 minute hate. The 2 minute hate is about to begin.
It's hate time, Winston.
Yes, I know. Here.
Comrades of Oceania in England, North America, South America, Australia, stand by for a message from our devoted leader, Big Brother.
Comrades, repeat after me. War is peace.
War is peace.
Freedom is slavery.
Freedom is slavery.
Ignorance is strength.
Ignorance is strength.
Comrades, in a moment, you will hear the despised Goldstein, whose shadowy armies conspire to destroy our new happy life. Listen to his lies, comrades. Then show him what you think.
Friends, countrymen of Oceania,
I am
Emmanuel Goldstein.
Traitor!
Your ex-leader and still your friend.
I am still working for your liberty, your freedom.
Criminal!
I am no traitor. In the past, I was one of the leaders of your revolution.
Swan!
Today, I am in hiding, sometimes in exile, but eternally working for your liberation.
Liar!
Big Brother is false to you. He has usurped power.
Liar!
He is a ruthless, bloody tyrant. He lies. He talks to you of a new, happy life while he starves your bodies and buries your souls. That they are endowed by the Creator with certain inalienable rights. Among these are life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness.
Criminal!
Remember the past. Cast off your chains. Free yourselves. Down with Big Brother. Down with Big Brother. Down with Big Brother.
Our comrade has the right spirits, but we have been deprived of 47 seconds of our hate. We will make up for it tomorrow, comrades. Now, back to work. All hail, Big Brother.
All hail, Big Brother.
Did you see that golden stick? Absolutely splendid, like I thought she was going to try to climb right through the telescreen to get a Goldstein throat. Tigress.
She's a member of the Thoughtlings.
Thoughtlings? How do you know?
I know.
How?
She's been watching. It's been going on for weeks. A month ago I saw her looking at me in the mess hall. That was the first time I noticed.
That's hardly a reason to think.
But there have been other times. Lots of them. Just last week I was in the pro section of London. Looking for shoes.
Find any? I say, old man, I need shoes badly.
No.
Been wearing the same pair for 2 years now.
I found no shoes, but I saw her watching me from across the street. I see her on the bus in the mornings on my way to work.
She stands by me at neighborhood hates and sits by me at restaurants. Everywhere I go, she turns up.
Well?
What else could it mean but not police? Today she begins work at the very next desk? Why? What have I done?
Well, of course. After all, Bob Withers.
He is an unperson.
Well, yes. He was vaporized as a thought criminal. Worked right beside you for 18 months.
What do you mean?
Nothing, Winston. We are not only co-workers. We are also neighbors. I know you are a good party member.
Yes?
Well, I simply mean you should have recognized his defection.
We never spoke at work. It's not allowed.
But still, Winston, instinctively, you should have known. I knew. I was the one who turned him into the thought police.
You were?
Yes. Found him committing face crime. Saw he wasn't hissing at Goldstein at all. Didn't even look angry.
What happened?
He confessed everything.
Of course he would have. He even had a fear of heights. Why, once I saw him turn white just from looking out a window. And the window was shut.
Do you think it was fear? You think he wasn't guilty then?
Of course he was guilty. But just knowing he had a fear of heights, it would be simple for them to get him to confess to his crimes. I mean, if I were a thought criminal, and they put a rat in front of me, I'd confess to anything.
Well, yes, I suppose. You know, something's wrong in this room. Something. Oh, why, of course, it's the telescreen. Imagine, first time I can remember ever being in a room without a telescreen on.
Yes, it is strange being without it.
Well, I got a report to my new job. It is a promotion, Winston. I'm to organize the papers. Good girl, comrade. You showed the right spirit. A fine idea. Perfectly fine.
Now, where were we, comrade?
You were explaining doublethink.
Yes, thank you. Comrade Simon is due back any moment and can explain it better than I can. Simon is off compiling the 11th edition of the New Speak Dictionary.
I'm sorry I'm so ignorant.
I don't think you're ignorant. You're smart. Very smart.
Thank you, comrade.
Perhaps cunning is a better word.
Ah, there, comrades.
Hello, comrade. Comrade Simon, this is Comrade Judy.
Yes, you're the one who threw the dictionary. Prophetic. The right spirit, comrade. A bit hysterical, perhaps, but the correct attitude nonetheless. A newspeak, I would say simply good thinkful.
We need your help, comrade.
My help? How can I help?
Comrade Julia is from the fiction department. There, they still speak standard English. Here, of course, she must understand newspeak. She does not.
Indeed. Yes. We're getting the language into its final shape. The shape it's going to have when nobody speaks anything else.
It must be a lot of work inventing new words.
Oh, dear me. We don't invent new words. We destroy them. Scores of them, hundreds of them. Every day.
Destroy them?
Yes. We're cutting the language down to the bone. The 11th edition of the Newspeak Dictionary won't contain a single word that will become obsolete before the year 2050.
Do you really destroy words?
Indeed, yes. A beautiful thing, the destruction of words. Absolutely the best way to control thought. Of course, verbs and adjectives are the easiest to destroy. And nouns, too.
But how?
Well, what justification is there for a word that's the opposite of some other word?
Well, you must. I mean, well, take a word like good.
All right, take good. What need is there for a word like bad? Ungood will do just as well. Better, in fact, because it is an exact opposite.
How about better? Best?
How's that?
Good, better, best.
We simply say plus good or double plus good. Simple, isn't it? In the end, the whole notion of good and bad will be covered actually by one word. See the beauty of it? Of course, it was Big Brother's idea originally.
You make it sound as though the language will eventually be cut to where it will be difficult to think at all.
Exactly. We'll defeat Goldstein that way. Newspeak is the only language whose vocabulary gets smaller every year. Why? The whole aim of Newspeak is to narrow the range of thought.
But how does that stop Goldstein have any effect on thought crime?
Because in the end, it will make thought crime literally impossible. For there will be no words to express it.
No words?
For instance, take that gibberish of Goldstein's about all men being created equal and so forth. That would be impossible to render into Newspeak. Why, literally the closest you could come would be one word, crime think. You understand that, don't you, Winston? By 2050, when everyone speaks nothing but Newspeak, not a single human being alive would understand the conversation we are now having.
Except for the proletarians.
The proles are not human beings. All real knowledge of old speak will be destroyed by the year 2050, including literature. Chaucer, Shakespeare, Milton, all will exist only in Newspeak. I'm working on that now.
But their meanings?
The meanings, that will be changed into something quite different.
But why?
Orthodoxy.
Orthodoxy? Why, there'll be no thought at all as we understand it now.
But, of course, orthodoxy means not thinking. Not needing to think. Read your dictionary, comrade, and call on me for any explanations.
Thank you.
This afternoon, public hangings, Winston?
I'll be there. Now, you understand me?
Yes. I mean, no. I understand the words.
Well?
The why. I don't understand why.
Well?
I can't explain it. I should never have been given this job.
What do you want to be explained?
The why. Nothing adds up. It's like saying that 2 + 2 = 5.
And if 2 + 2 = 5?
Do you really believe that?
You want me to commit a thought crime, don't you? A speak crime, so you can report me? Do you think I'm a complete fool? I already know you're a member of the Dot Police.
No!
What proof are you after? You can frame me, you can say I said anything, the telescreen is broken! You broke it! Why continue this foolish
game? Don't think that of me, please!
What do you want me to say? I'll say
it! I'm not a member of the Dot Police!
Then why have you been spying on me? Why do you follow me around? Why are you suddenly working here? You don't think I've noticed you following me? Watching me? Looking at me out of the corners of your eyes? I thought that I would kill you once, but what good would that have done? They know who did!
I'm not!
Then why?
I love you!
What is all this? What is wrong?
You sent me a fool, Comrade O'Brien. Please have her transferred. She is no good.
You mean that Comrade Julia is not a good partner?
No, Comrade O'Brien. She's a devoted member of the party, but she... she makes mistakes. She's made the same mistake in punctuation 3 times.
Comrade Smith, what I am about to say cannot be said in Newspeak, but some words of old speak I still like to use. Instead of wrath, try a little gentleness, a little kindness. I believe then that Comrade Julie will learn. Why hasn't his telescreen been fixed yet? See to it immediately.
Yes, sir! Immediately!
Saved my life.
You're beautiful.
You lied to him.
You're so small. Like a child.
You protected me.
I've never seen a grown woman cry before.
I am a thought criminal. Why didn't you report me?
Because, Julie, I also believe that 2 + 2 must always be 4.
Comrade,
you say, how could this be? You say you love the county, that you worship your friend. How can you be a Butler? I'll tell you, Comrades. There are agents of Goldstein everywhere. They are lurking, waiting to poison your minds. But there is one way to stop them. To make yourself immune to their lies and treasons. And that, Comrades, is by using crime stop. Crime stop is political good thinking. Practice crime stop and you can never be guilty of thought crime. But these agents of Goldstein who are trying to destroy our new happiness. What of them?
Sir?
They could be the ones who work next to you. Perhaps even the next door neighbor.
What are you doing here?
I had to come.
Right in the view of the telescreen, Julia. You know we agreed never to be seen together.
You can't watch everybody all the time, can
you? I don't know. If they can, if they saw you come in, we'll know it soon enough.
Darling, I had to come.
It would be death for us both if they catch you.
Don't look that way, please. I know it is a gamble. Please don't be angry. Kiss me. Please.
Julia, what if someone saw you in the hallway?
Everyone is listening to the propaganda. I'm not stupid, Winston. I take risks, yes, if they are calculated risks. Only a child's risk.
Not Parsons, Brett.
Who's Parsons?
That's Fat Cow. She went to the next office. You've seen her. She lives right across the hall.
I'm sorry. But I had such good news. I had to tell you.
Then tell me quickly. You must leave before the guards close the streets. What is it?
We can be married.
What?
We can be married. I found someone to marry us.
How? Where? Whom did you find?
One question at a time.
Then for heaven's sake, tell me quickly.
Well, some of the pros still have churches.
I didn't know that.
They're all hidden and hard to find, but a few still exist.
And you found them? And someone who can marry us?
An old priest, a minister, well, I don't know exactly what he is, but he says he can marry us.
When? When will he do
it? Anytime.
Tomorrow?
No, next week's the time. I've been elected block 10 of anti-sexual. Our meetings start tomorrow. Wouldn't they be surprised if we knew?
We can really be married next week.
Yes.
It may be a trap.
Winston Smith, are you trying to get out of marriage?
No. I want to marry him more than I've ever wanted anything. It's just, I'd about given up hope. Big Brother doesn't believe in marriage. How on earth did you do it?
I went to O'Brien.
What?
He told me whom to contact.
You idiot, you stupid little idiot! You killed us both!
Don't say that! I've saved us!
O'Brien's black suit! He's in a party!
O'Brien is a friend. He won't harm us.
How can you say that?
Because it's true! Who do you think made it possible for me to work with you in the Ministry of Truth?
O'Brien?
Of course.
But that means he's a traitor.
I don't know about that. But he's very understanding.
Julia, how can you be sure?
He's an old friend. I've known him for years. He's always been helpful to me.
You're lucky to have a friend in Anapata.
Isn't it wonderful?
Yes.
He'll help us.
But it's so dangerous.
If you won't trust him, will you trust me?
Of course.
All right, then marry me.
I want to.
I love you so much. It's been terrible to work side by side and be afraid to show it. Even to be afraid to glance at you because of the telescreen.
I know, but we must be careful. It could mean our lives.
But when we're married, we must have a place where we can be together.
I have the place. I found one. It's over a junk shop down in the pro section. It's a little room. A lovely, happy little room. I've rented it. We can move in next week.
Oh, Winston.
Julia, what do you see in me? I'm ineffective, ugly, old-fashioned.
I couldn't care less.
But why me, Julia?
It's your face. Something in your eyes. I recognize you immediately. I knew you hated the party as much as I did. You get to tell.
One, I leave.
Kiss me, darling. Then you must go.
You're not angry?
No, I've never heard such great news.
You understand why I had to tell you.
Yes.
Aren't you happy? You look nervous. What's wrong?
Nothing, really.
What is it, Winston?
They were Jones, Aronson, and Ruffin, the original leaders of the revolution, along with Goldstein and Big Brother.
I remember. They turned counter-revolutionists, didn't they? I read about them in my history book. They confessed and the purge of 1970 and were vaporized.
Goldstein escaped.
And only Big Brother was left. Well, it's about them.
They weren't vaporized in 1970. It was 1975. They were arrested in 1970 but were allowed to go free. I saw them once in the Chestnut Tree Cafe. They were old, broken down men just drinking victory coffee. I remember seeing tears rolling down the cheeks of Ruffin. I saw the man take their picture.
Why are they so important?
Because later on that same year, they were arrested again. They'd confessed to being flown to a secret meeting place in India and were giving information to the general staff at the station. We were fighting the station.
Still don't understand why you're so excited.
Don't you see? The date on this picture, and they were the same dates that I saw them in the Chestnut Tree Cafe. It means all of their confessions were lies. They weren't in India. They were here in London, in that cafe.
Where did you get this?
It was on my desk, brought to me with other pieces of paper. A mistake for me.
Why didn't you destroy it immediately?
I couldn't. It's visible evidence of what's been going on. Entire history's being changed.
But Winston, that's your job. What's so important about the past? The future that's important.
The past has been abolished. All records have been destroyed or altered. Every book rewritten. Already we know nothing about the years before the revolution. It's my job to help falsify the past, but never before have I had visible evidence to prove it. Except for this. This!
You must destroy it, Winston!
You're right. But it will mean our final loss of freedom.
Freedom? Freedom? What is freedom, Winston? Maybe the party is right. Maybe freedom is slavery.
No! Freedom is the freedom to say 2 + 2 = 4. If that is granted, all else follows.
I love you, darling. But I don't understand you.
Your whole hatred of the party is based on the fact that it won't let you do what you want to do. Like get married to me.
But now we're going to be married.
Yes.
So now I don't hate anyone. Why do you hate so hard?
I'm not yet certain. You must go. I'd better turn up the telescope.
Abigail! You're a traitor! A thought criminal! A Eurasian spy! I'll shoot you! You had a woman in your rooms! I'll vaporize you! I'll send you to the salt mine!
Stop making all that noise! You're a good spy, but you shouldn't say things like that about Comrade Smith. Even in play. Now it's time for bed. I'm sorry, Winston. You know how children are. Lettice is only 14, but already she knows all the words. How they teach them among spies.
Goldfish!
Yes! You know, Winston, she has a toy ear trumpet so she can listen through keyhole. Only a toy, of course. That is worse. You know what this means. It's death report for women in the party number 2.
Yes, I know.
I must report you.
I know.
Hard to believe. Always thought you were a good thinker, Smith. Well, you never know. All right. I know my duty.
Parsons!
What is it?
She's a member of the Lotlights.
My goodness, I did have the right eye on you. Well, I better hurry. It'll look bad if I don't report to you before she does. After all, I'm your neighbor.
Parsons, it's not me she's spying on.
What? Who's that?
It's you.
me.
That's why she was here. She was questioning me. She asked if I had ever seen you commit facepalm.
Oh, no. Oh, dear, how could she? Oh, I've been seeing an actual neighbor. You know me.
Yes, Parsons. I know you.
I've been a good party member all my life. I was in the Spartan year before I was of age. When I was only 10, my picture was in the Times as a child's hero.
Yes, Parsons.
I reported my uncle to the dog police. I complained about the chocolate rations. This is monstrous. What? Hugh, what else did you tell her instead?
I told her you were a do-gooder, a double plus good thing, a devoted worshipper of Big Brother.
Love him. I love Big Brother.
I believe I convinced him, but I wouldn't speak of this. Not to anyone.
Oh, no. No, no, not a word.
Just be careful, Parsons.
You're a good man, Smith.
You better go back to your room. Propaganda hour is almost over.
Yes. Thank you, Smith. Thank you, boy. I'll never forget it.
And Parsons, Comrade Julius said that Gladys is making too much racket. She also asked if you would encourage her to call party members by vile names.
I'll tend to Gladys, Smith. That brat. I'll fix her.
How can you tell about criminal comrades? The easiest way is face crime. Look carefully at the ones you suspect. Do they look unhatefully at Goldstein? Do they look unlovingly at Big Brother? Yes, comrades, face crime is thought crime. Report these agents of Goldstein to your nearest thought police. The thought police helicopter will be there immediately. Yes, comrades.
Welcome home, darling.
Home, yes. This is our home now, isn't it?
Maybe I should have carried you across the threshold. I heard people used to do something like that.
But it's such a steep threshold. All those steps.
There should be something more. A symbol, some kind of ceremony, maybe. I don't know.
What's the matter with the ceremony we just had? Wasn't the preacher funny?
Funny?
The way he whistled when he spoke. He didn't have any teeth in front.
He's an old man. He hates the party. He knows we do too.
I hate the party too. But I'm smart about it.
Oh,
Saturdays to the Children's Spies Organization. I always carry a flag or banner of some sort in the parades. In fact, I'm very well thought of. Why do you hate the party? What started you?
It's hard to explain. Because 2 + 2 = 4. Not 5 or 7 or whatever the party says it is. Because there must have been a time in the past when people lived differently.
You really think the old days were better?
They must have been. Thought was free and men lived differently from one another. And families lived together.
How old were you when the revolution happened?
6, maybe 7.
Can you remember it?
Some little insignificant things, like...
Oh, miss.
What was it?
A rat.
Don't say that word!
I'll put up the whole filthy thing won't be able to get back in. I hate rats!
Julia!
I'm sorry! Winston, what's wrong? You're actually trembling.
I can't stand them. Not even the word. A thing happened when I was a child. I can't even bear thinking of them.
I'm sorry, darling. I suppose all of us have one thing we literally cannot stand. As for me, it's... Well, never mind. We haven't much time.
No, we haven't much time. Julia, you know the secret organization? The conspiracy, the book, Goldstein's book?
Certainly. Everyone's heard of them, but no one's actually seen them. They're all invented by the party to keep us scared.
No, they exist.
How do you know?
O'Brien spoke to me again yesterday at lunch.
I thought you were nervous yesterday. You just don't trust him.
I think I do now. He congratulated me on my work. That's the third time. He even invited me to his apartment to pick up the latest edition of the Newspeak Dictionary.
That means it's a conspiracy.
It must. O'Brien's in a pub. He didn't have to invite me to his home for something as simple as that.
That's not proof of anything.
Besides, he helped us get married. Would he do such a thing if he weren't a conspiracy? Don't you see, Julie? Bringing us together means he does care. And that he wants to fight back too. Don't you see that, Julie?
I don't know. Doesn't seem reasonable. Helping us be together is one thing, but... Being a traitor is something else. After all, he is an official, a member...
A member of the inner party, I know. That's what makes it practical for him. I tell you, Julia, there's something about him. Something in his eyes, a look. He's one of us, I know. Surely you can understand that.
Yes. I can understand that. That's the way I discovered you, darling. When should we go see him?
So you agree that we should?
Where else can we turn?
That's just it. I don't know. Are you sure you went to get mixed up in this organization?
If there is a conspiracy, and if you want to join, then I want to join. I want to be with you, darling.
Agreed then. As soon as possible, I'll get in touch with Commander O'Brien. We'll go see him together.
Managed to run a bit curtain for you. Not that it'll do much good. It's that old. Now, it was old Prince you happened to be interested in. Or old furniture. These things is for sale, you know.
I think I've seen this before. Say. The spray must pass into the wall.
Churches! Can't trust nobody. Kids around here are selling anything they can sell. You can unscrew it, I dare say, if you want to move it.
I know that building. It's the war museum.
As may be. Used to be a church, it did. St. Clement's Dane. Oh, it was bombed back in, years ago. Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement's.
What's that?
Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement's. It was a rhyme we had back when I was a girl. It goes on, oh. I don't remember, but I do know it ended. Here comes a candle to light you to bed. Here comes a chopper to chop off your egg. It was a carnival dance. They held their arms out for you to pass under. And when they got to here comes a chopper to chop off your egg, they brought them down and cut you. It was the names of all the churches. All the big ones in London was in it.
You must have seen great changes since you were a young girl.
The gym was better. There was beer too. Mild beer. Wallop, we used to call it back when I was a girl. 4 pence a pint. That was before the war, of course.
Which war was that?
It's all wars, dearie. Oh, me feet. Don't suppose you got any extra shoe coupons, do you?
No, we don't. What I really wanted to know was this. In those days, did you have more freedom?
Freedom?
Yes, freedom to live where you want, to marry whom you want, freedom to do as you wish.
To wear a hat even, a pretty hat.
Hats! Funny you should mention them. The same thing came into my head only yesterday. I was just thinking, I haven't seen a hat with ribbons in years. Last time I wore one was at my sister-in-law's funeral. And that was, 50 years ago. It was only had for the occasion, you understand.
It isn't very important about the hats. The point is, are you treated more like a human being today? In the old days, the rich people, the people at the top, they...
The House of Lords.
The House of Lords, if you like. What I'm asking is, were they able to treat you as inferior simply because they were rich and you were poor? Did you have to knuckle under them?
Oh, they like you to drop them a curtsy now and again, show respect, like. I didn't agree with it much myself, but I've done it enough, as you might say.
I haven't made myself quite clear. You lived half your life before the revolution. Would you say that life before the revolution was better or worse than it is now? If you had the choice, would you prefer to live then or now?
I know what you expect me to say. You expect me to say I'd rather be young again. Most people say they'd rather be young again. You asked them. You got your health and your strength when you're young. When you get to my time of life, you ain't never well. I suffer something wicked from me feet and me kidneys. It's just terrible. On the other hand, there are some advantages to being an old woman. Ain't got the same worries. No truck with men. And that's a good thing! It was only a hopeless fancy. It passed like an April day. But a look and a word, the dreams that they stirred, they stole me out away.
That's really the point, isn't it? I've had my dreams and I can remember what they was like. You remember?
Sam's gone now, but what we had, no big brother could take away. I remember it. Here. They say that time heals all things. They say you can always forget. But the smiles and the tears, across all the years, they twist me heartstrings yet. Well, ta-ta, dearies. If you need anything, just stick it out the window and holler. I probably won't have it, but you can holler.
The pros of the human beings. She, all of them. We are not human.
Why not?
We are the dead.
No! We are the living. You've got to remember that. As long as we have feelings, we are the living.
No, we are the dead. We have no past, no dreams to remember.
But we have a future, a time to make our own dreams.
Maybe. Has it ever occurred to you, Julie, that the best thing for us to do would be to turn around before it's too late and never see each other again?
Yes, dear. It has occurred to me several times. But I'm not going to do it all the same.
We've been lucky, but it can't last. You look young and innocent. If you stay clear of people like me, you can live up to another 50 years.
No, I've thought it all out. What you do, I'm going to do. And let's not be too downhearted. We've stayed alive this long.
We'll be together for another 6 months, a year, there's no telling. In the end, we're certain to be apart.
Yes.
Do you realize how utterly alone we shall be?
Yes.
Once they have a hold of us, there will be nothing, literally nothing that either of us can do for the other. If I confess, they'll shoot you.
And if you refuse to confess, they'll shoot me, just the same.
There will be nothing that I can do or say or stop myself from saying that can save them. Neither of us will even know if the other is alive or dead.
I know.
The one thing we mustn't do is betray one another. We must never do that, even if it doesn't make the slightest of a difference.
If you mean confessing, we'll do that soon enough. Everybody always confesses, you can't help it.
Confession isn't betrayal. What you say or do doesn't matter. Only feelings matter. You were right about that, Julie. If they could make me stop loving you, that would be the real betrayal.
They can't do that. It's the one thing they can't do. Even that woman, that pro, she still remembers her son. They can make you say anything, anything, but they can't make you believe it. They can't get inside you, can they?
No, that's quite true. They can't get inside you. If you feel that staying human is worthwhile, even when it has no result whatever, you've beaten me.
Oh, darling. Darling, then we've already won. No matter what happens, we've beaten him. They have only hate, and we have love. So long as we love, we've won.
We're here to see Comrade O'Brien.
Is he expecting you?
No. Yes. I'm not sure. He asked us to drop in.
May I have your names, please?
This is Comrade Julia, and I'm Smith. Winston Smith.
Thank you. Can you please be seated?
We'll call Comrade O'Brien.
Things like these come from?
I have no idea. The inner party gets special privileges.
Look at this, Winston. It's most as big as our bed. It's like sponge or deep grass. Oh, feel it, Winston. It's like a cloud. Come on, Winston.
Julia, stop that. What if Comrade O'Brien came?
Martin told us to sit down.
Well, sit. Don't bounce.
I wonder what it's made of.
I don't know.
Oh, I can't believe it. Look.
What beautiful steel.
That's silver.
Silver?
They used to make things out of it in the old days. Candlesticks, dishes, teapots.
Whatever for?
Simply because it was beautiful. No other reason.
Imagine.
Oh, look, it's a box for cigarettes.
Put it down, Julie.
Did you ever own any silver? Your family owned it?
No. But I heard there were whole shop windows full of it once. Big platters, coffee urns, things like that. Maybe I'm just imagining them.
I know it was called silver. Oh, I'd love to have a silver box.
Julia, please.
What's the matter, darling? You're awfully nervous. What's wrong?
Maybe this is all a mistake.
What's a mistake?
Our being. I honestly don't know if he's one of us.
But he asked you to come.
Yes. To pick up a dictionary. I wonder, is that all he meant? Nothing more. Suppose it's a trap.
Then we'll be vaporized. We'll be unpersonal.
No! Don't say that! You turned it off.
Yes. I turned it off. We members of the inner party have that privilege. All right. Shall I say it, or will you?
I will say it. That thing is really turned off.
Yes. Everything is turned off. We are alone.
We are here because we believe there is some kind of conspiracy. Some kind of secret organization working against the party, and that you are part of it. We want to join it. We want to work for it.
We are enemies of the party.
We disbelieve in its principles.
We're thought criminals.
We're married.
We tell you this because we want to put ourselves at your mercy.
If you would like us to incriminate ourselves in any other way, we're ready.
Don't be alarmed. Martin is one of us. Put the wine on the table, Martin, and sit down. This is business. You can stop being a servant for the next 10 minutes. Yes, sir. Don't be upset. It's not blood. It's called wine. You've read about it in books, no doubt. Not much of it makes it to the outer party, I'm afraid, but I thought it only fitting that we should begin by drinking a toast to our leader, to Emmanuel Goldstein.
So there is such a person as Goldstein?
Yes, and he is alive. Where? I don't know.
It's not just something the Thought Police made up.
No, it's real enough. The Brotherhood, we call it. You'd better go back to the pantry, Mark. I shall be switching on again in a few minutes. Take a good look at these comrades' faces before you go. You will be seeing them again. I may not. It is unwise, even for a member of the inner party, to switch off for more than a few minutes. We have about 12 minutes left. Incidentally, you ought not to have come here together. That was very unwise. Double plus on good, in fact. When you leave, you will leave separately. Comrade Julius, you will leave first. Now, what are you prepared to do?
Anything we are capable of doing.
You are prepared to give your life?
Yes.
You are prepared to commit murder?
Yes.
You are prepared to commit acts of sabotage, to cause the deaths of hundreds of innocent people?
Yes.
To betray your country?
Yes.
You are prepared to do anything to weaken the power of the party?
Yes, anything.
You would, if necessary, throw acid in a child's face?
Yes.
You are prepared to commit suicide, if and when we order you to do so?
Yes.
Are you prepared, the two of you, to separate and to never see one another again?
No!
No.
You did well to tell me. It is necessary that we know everything. You realize that even if he survives, it may be as a different person. His face, the color of his hair, even his voice may be different. And you, yourself. Our surgeons can alter people beyond recognition. Sometimes it is necessary to amputate a limb. Good. Then it is settled. There are a couple of minutes before you need to go. But first, let us finish the wine. What shall it be this time? To the confusion of the Thought Police? To the death of Big Brother? To humanity? To the future?
To the past.
Yes. I know what you mean. The past is more important. To the past. have a hiding place?
Yes.
Where is it?
It's over a junk shop down in the Pro Center.
You shouldn't have told me. The less any of us know, the better. Later, we will arrange something more permanent for you. You must change your hiding places frequently. In the meantime, I'll send you a copy of the book.
Dolce's book?
Yes.
It exists!
Yes, but it may be a few days before I can get hold of a copy. There are only a few left. Do you carry a briefcase?
As a rule, yes.
What's it like?
Black, shabby, one strap.
Sometime in the near future, you will receive a message among your morning work. It will contain a misprinted word. You will have to ask for a reprint. The next morning, you will leave your briefcase at home.
Then what?
At some point during that day, a man in the street will touch your arm and say, "I think you dropped your briefcase." The one he gives you will contain a copy of the book. You will return it within 14 days. So all that's understood?
Yes.
We shall meet again. If we do meet again.
In the place where there's no darkness.
In the place where there is no darkness. Is there anything you wish to say? Any message, any question?
Do you know the old, old rhyme that begins, "Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement's."
Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement's. You owe me 3 farthings, say the bells of St. Martin's. When will you pay me, say the bells of Old Bailey? When I grow rich, say the bells of Shoreditch.
You know the rhyme?
Yes, I know the rhyme. And now, I think you'd better go.
Oranges and lemons, say the bells of St. Clement's.
You owe me 3 farthings, say the bells of St. Martin's.
When will you pay me, say the bells of Old Bailey?
When I grow rich, say the bells of Shoreditch.
Where are you going? Wait a moment, I have a surprise for you.
I have a surprise for you too. Don't look now. Don't keep.
I won't look. What is it that smells so nice?
Another surprise.
I've smelled this aroma before. It was in the home of an inner party. What is it?
It's coffee. Real coffee.
I've never had real coffee before. I can hardly wait.
It's not at all like Victory Coffee. Doesn't it smell wonderful?
What's this?
What's what?
The white sand.
That's sugar.
Sugar, not saccharin. Real sugar. Yes, I remember it now. I've tasted this before. Where did you get all of these things?
Oh, here and there, the black market.
But this is in a party food. I've never heard of it on the black market.
Oh, you men. They have servants, don't they? And servants steal, don't they? And they must have a place to sell what they steal, mustn't they?
But what if the patrol stopped you when they saw you carrying all of those things? You know what they'd do if they saw you carrying in a party. Why take such foolish risks?
It was worth it. You'll see.
Don't talk nonsense.
I'm not talking nonsense.
Oh, you delightful, crazy fool. They'd shoot you if they caught you.
Don't you like my little surprises?
I love them.
Trading on the black market is a crime against the party, isn't it? You see, I'm helping Goldstein by helping myself. So there. Wait till you see my big surprise. Don't peek now.
I have the big surprise for you. Guess what?
Well, I can't guess. Tell me.
The book.
Oh, that's wonderful. What book, dear?
Goldstein's book.
Oh, how nice. You read. I'll be out in just another minute.
Come out now. I want us to read it together.
Go ahead. Read out loud. I'm listening.
Isn't this a wonderful room? Isn't it truly fabulous? No telescreen, no pictures of Big Brother. We can say what we want, look like we want, think like we want. If only it could last forever.
Did Goldstein say that?
No, I did. I was just thinking out loud.
Well, read, darling. I'm almost ready.
The Theory and Practice of Allegorical Collectivism by Emmanuel Goldstein. Chapter 1, Ignorance is Strength. Throughout recorded time, there have been three kinds of people in the world: the high, the middle, and the low. They have been subdivided in many ways, but the essential structure of society has never altered. Julia, it is the book!
What, dear?
I'm actually reading the book!
That's what I thought you were doing.
I can't believe it. I want to read it all at once. That's how excited I am.
Start in the middle. If the middle is any good, then go back to the beginning. If not, then why bother?
Maybe you're right. Chapter 3. War is Peace. The splitting up of the world into three great superstates was foreseen before the middle of the 20th century. And since that time, the three superstates have been permanently at war. The primary aim of modern warfare is to use up the products of the machine without raising the general standard of living. The essential act of war is destruction of the products of human labor. War is a way of shattering to pieces the materials which otherwise might be used to make the masses too comfortable, and hence in the long run too intelligent. So long as they remain in conflict, they prop one another up like three sheaves of corn. And the very word war, therefore, has become misleading. This is the inner meaning of the party slogan, war is peace. Julia, did you hear that?
Yes, dear.
It's wonderful, it's unbelievable.
What's so unbelievable about it? I've heard you say pretty much the same things.
What's important is that it's written down. It means that there are people on this earth that feel the same way as I do. I'm not mad.
Of course you're not mad.
There is truth and there is untruth. And if you cling to truth even against the whole world, you aren't mad.
You're brilliant, my love. As brilliant as Goldstein.
Come out now. Come here, please. I want us to read it from the beginning.
All right. But you've got to close your eyes. Have you closed?
Julia.
Look, it's my surprise. I'm a woman. That's too big anyway.
You are beautiful.
Winston, this is the only time I've ever felt like a woman. A real woman. And you are my man. My husband. A real dress. Think of it. Think of what the party will say.
Where did you get it?
I spent all of my clothing coupons on it. A whole year's supply. I'll be ragged before the year's out. But I don't care. I have a dress. It's like what the pearl women wear, isn't it?
No, your dress is pretty. Theirs are just sacks. But it is a dress, my angel. A beautiful, beautiful dress.
You like me in it?
I adore you.
Talk to me then.
But the book, darling.
I don't care about the book. You should pay some more attention to your wife.
All right, I'll put it down. But first, let me finish chapter one.
You like the book more than you do me.
Julia, it's the book. I must return it. Surely you can understand that.
All right. You read your book, and I'll serve the coffee.
Throughout recorded time, there have been three kinds of people in the world. The high, the middle, and the low.
You read that!
The aims of these groups are entirely irreconcilable. The aim of the high is to remain where they are. The aim of the middle is to change places with the high. There are only four ways the ruling group can fall from power. One, it is conquered from without, or two, it governs so inefficiently that the masses are stirred to revolt. Or three, it allows a strong and discontented middle group to come into being. Or four, it loses its own self-confidence and will to govern.
Winston, do you think I have pretty legs?
What?
Well, do you?
Yes. Have you even been listening?
I have to. It's funny, but legs look different this way, coming out of a dress. Don't you think legs are different this way?
Are you going to listen?
Of course, but the coffee's almost ready. You read, and I'll bring the coffee.
Not even the smallest deviation of opinion can be tolerated. A party member lives from birth to death under the eye of the dogmas. Even when he is alone, he can never be sure he is alone. Nothing that he does is indifferent. He has no freedom of choice in any direction. He is expected to have no private emotions, no respite from enthusiasm, and is supposed to live in a continuous frenzy of hatred, of foreign enemies, and internal traitors. Supposed to?
After all the trouble and risk of finding it, you certainly are.
Sugar, please.
One teaspoon of two.
Two, if you don't mind.
Of course.
It's delicious. What a wonderful taste, really.
Some people prefer it with milk.
The discontent produced by this bare, unsatisfying life is deliberately turned outward and dissipated by such devices as the 2 minute hate and the... I can't compete with the pro singer.
I don't force you to!
Julia.
I spent my money and my coupons to make you happy. By serving real coffee with sugar for the first time in our lives. And I'm serving them in a dress that's supposed to make me look beautiful for you just this once. I want to feel like a wife, a real woman, not a party member, not a conspirator, just a wife trying to make her husband happy. And you keep reading that damn book. You don't love me.
No, no, my darling, my angel. Of course I love you. Forever.
They say the time is lost. They say you can't.
not important. I already understand the how. I just don't yet understand the why. I do know what the conclusions must be then.
What, my darling?
There.
The landlady.
Yes. If there is hope, any at all, it lies with the probes.
I wonder how she survives.
Think of her, Jimmy. That woman has grown fat from childbirth and been hardened and rustled by the work to keep her children alive. She's beautiful.
She's at least a yard across the hips.
That's her style of beauty. Don't you see, Jimmy? All around the world, in Eurasia, East Asia, and Oceania, there are women bearing children, washing and singing. The pros sing and the birds sing. Only the party does not sing. They are the hope truth, and we are the dead.
We are the dead.
You are dead.
It was behind the picture!
It was behind the picture. Stay where you are. Do not move.
The house is surrounded!
The house is surrounded. Place your hands behind your head. Stand absolutely still.
We may as well say goodbye.
Why not go out around this soft? It puts the candles light my bed. Chop close to your head.
I never suspected you. I thought it was you who denounced me.
What did you do, son?
I really don't know.
There's only one event.
Yes. Of course. Thought crime.
Did you commit it?
Apparently.
You know,
I think maybe we had finished the dictionary, complete, everything done. I'd been working on poetry, translating the poems of Kipling into Newspeak. We were calling him Big Brother's Trumpeter. I allowed the word God to remain at the end of a line. I couldn't help it. The rhyme was rod. There are only 12 other rhymes to rod in the entire language. There was no way for me to change it. No way at all.
I wonder where we are.
Mini-love.
Where?
Ministry of Love, of course.
I know that. Where in the building?
Who cares? It all ends the same. You're walking down a corridor, and they shoot you in the back of the head.
Are you afraid?
No. No. Of course, they won't take me to room 101. I haven't done anything that bad. No. No. I'm really not afraid.
What for?
Oh, you don't think they'll shoot me? Maybe Marge is even 10 years. They would shoot me just going for us to work.
Are you guilty?
Of course I'm guilty. You don't think the party went out to this person, do you? I can see it. Never had any idea that what's done with my mind, but you were saying, don't look, Big Brother. Don't look, Big Brother. Yes, I said that. I said that. I'm not even getting my smart, hey? Proud of them. Surely they brought her up in the right spirit.
Sir! Room 101!
No, please! No!
Not 101. No. It's not me you want. It's him!
No, please!
He says against the party. Him, not me!
No, wait, please, no! My 101! No, please! Wait! Winston! Help me! No, please, wait! No!
They'll
take me
to room 101, will they? Parsons! What is in room 101?
I don't know. I'm not sure. I think I know. I'm not sure.
Where is it, sir? So they got you too?
They got me a long time ago, Winston. You knew this, Winston. Don't deceive yourself. I told you we would meet again in the place where there is no darkness. Room 101!
No, please! I'm lying now, please! Please, stop! Please, what did I do? Please, someone!
Don't worry, Winston. Now that you've been suitably prepared, I shall save you. I shall make you perfect.
Yes.
I am taking trouble with you, Winston.
Why? I've already confessed.
Confession, suffer propaganda.
Then why did you starve me and keep me standing for weeks? Why wasn't I allowed to sleep? Why were the lights never turned off?
You don't understand. There was nothing to confess that we didn't already know.
What are you trying to do?
You suffer from a mental derangement. You believe you remember things that never happened. You are worth saving. We're going to save you. Stand up. That's better. You must always stand and pay attention. You have the delusion that you saw this picture of Jones, Aronson, and Rutherford. You believe this proves they could not have committed the crimes they confessed to.
It exists!
No, it does not exist. Destroy it. You see? It doesn't exist. You won't even see the destruction of its pieces. In fact, it never existed.
It still exists. And memory. I remember it. You remember it.
I do not remember it.
Double think! You're a lunatic! No. You don't actually remember it, do you?
Repeat the party's slogan dealing with control of the past.
Who controls the past controls the future. Who controls the present controls the past.
Is there a place? A world of solid objects where the past is still happening?
No.
Then where?
And records.
In records and?
And the mind. And human memories.
And we, the part, control all records into all memories. Thus, we control the past, do we not?
Memory is involuntary. You can't control it. You haven't controlled mine.
You have not controlled your memory. You believe that reality is something objective, external. But reality exists in the human mind and nowhere else.
All right. And the human mind?
The individual mind can make mistakes. But the mind of the party is immortal. What the party holds to be truth is truth. You must humble yourself before you can become sane. How many fingers am I holding up, Winston?
Four.
The party says that it is not four, but five. How many are there?
Four.
How many fingers, Winston?
Four.
You are slow to learn. Perhaps we have been feeding you too well.
How can I help seeing what is in front of my eyes? Two and two are four.
Sometimes they are five, and sometimes they are three. You must try harder. It isn't easy to become sane. How many fingers, Winston?
Four. I suppose there are four. I would see five if I could. I'm trying to see five.
Do you wish to persuade me that you see five fingers or really see them?
Really to see them.
Then tell me, how many fingers am I holding up, Winston?
Four, five, six, in all honesty, I just don't know.
Your arithmetic is double plus, I'm good, Winston. You will have to go back to school until you can do better.
Two and two are five. Repeat it after me, Smith. Two and two are five. 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 Repeat it after me, Smith. Two and two are five. Two and two are five. Two and two are five. Two plus two makes five. Two plus two makes five. Repeat it after me, Smith. Two plus two makes five.
Two plus two makes four. Two plus two is four.
Two plus two
is four.
Two plus two
is four. Two plus two is four.
1,000 times, 2 plus 2 is 5!
It isn't true! I won't do it! 2 and 2!
You will do it!
These are supposed to learn. Count them. And after 5, then you can sleep.
One and one are two.
Unless you have all 4.
You may sleep when you see 5.
That's right, Winston. Count them. Count them, my darling. As soon as you see that 4 makes 5, you may sleep. It's easy to sleep, Winston, and it's good, so good. Count your 5 blocks, darling. Count them with me. 2 on one side, and 2 on the other. That makes 5. See how easy it is? 2 plus 2. Make 5. Say it with me, darling, and then we can both sleep. 2 plus 2 make 5. 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 2 plus 2 makes 5.
2 plus 2 makes 5.
And a while back, you created a false legend about 3 men you thought you had a photograph of. Do you remember the exact moment you invented that lie?
Yes.
Good. Now, just a moment. I returned your gloves to you. You had 5 of them. Do you remember that?
Yes.
There are 5 gloves here, Winston. Do you see 5 blocks?
Yes.
I agree. It's difficult, but you begin to know it is possible.
Yes.
I like talking to you, Winston. Your mind resembles my own, except that you were insane. Is there anything you would like to ask?
What have you done to Julia?
She betrayed you, Winston. Immediately and unreservedly. It was a perfect conversion. A textbook case. We didn't even have to starve her.
You tortured her.
No. Torture is too brief in its effect. We re-educated her, using the appropriate incentives.
Does Big Brother exist?
Of course he exists. The party exists. Big Brother is the embodiment.
Does he exist in the same way I exist?
You do not exist.
I think. I exist. I was born and I shall die.
It is of no importance. He exists.
Will Big Brother ever die?
Of course not. How can he die? Next question.
Does the Brotherhood exist?
That is something you will never know, Winston. Even if we choose to let you live, it will be an unsolved riddle.
What is in room 101?
You know what is in room 101, Winston. The truth is here. How many things?
Five.
Thief. Let him sleep for 2 hours, then call me. There are 3 stages in your reintegration. There is learning, there is understanding, there is acceptance. You have accomplished the learning. Now, it is time to begin the second stage. In reading Goldstein's book, did you learn anything you did not already know?
Have you read it?
I wrote it.
Is it true? What it says?
As a description, yes. As a program, no. The party cannot be overthrown. The rule of the party is forever. But why? What is our motive? Why should we want power?
You rule over us for our own good.
That was stupid. Stupid. The party seeks power entirely for its own sake. The object of persecution is persecution. The object of torture is torture. The object of power is power.
You speak of power and forever, and yet you are growing old. You too, O'Brien, must die!
I am only a servant. The party will live forever. Tell me, Winston, how does one man assert his power over another?
By making him suffer.
Exactly. Power is inflicting pain, tearing human minds to pieces and putting them together again. Do you begin to see what kind of world we are preparing? It will be a world of fear and treachery and torment. Progress in our world will be a progress in more pain.
Is there no room for love in the world?
In our world, there will be no emotions except fear, treachery, triumph, and self-abasement. Everything else we shall destroy. Everything! If you want a picture of the future, imagine a boot stamping on a human face. Forever. That is the world we are preparing. And you will accept it, Winston. Welcome to become a boot. What? What's that?
You cannot create such a world. It is impossible.
Why?
You cannot found a civilization on hatred and cruelty. It would never endure.
Why not?
It would disintegrate. It would commit suicide.
Nonsense. You are under the impression that hatred is more exhausting than love. Even if it is, the individual's life may be shorter, but the party goes on.
Yet somehow you will fail. Something will defeat you. Life will defeat you. The spirit of man will defeat you.
And do you consider yourself a man?
Yes.
You actually consider yourself superior to us?
Yes. I consider myself superior.
You do. You are superior? You're nothing more than a skeleton. You're in rags, your teeth are gone. If you're the way the last man looks, the spirit of man can have you for a guardian.
You've done this to me!
You have done this to yourself. Nothing has happened to you that you did not foresee in your first act of thoughtfulness. You've confessed to everything. You've pled for mercy. Your mind has been reconstructed. Is there any single degradation that has not happened to you?
I still haven't betrayed Julia.
Why, you have told us everything.
I still haven't betrayed her.
No. No, perhaps not.
How long before they will shoot me?
It might be a long time. You are a difficult case, Winston. You have hidden strength. But don't forget. Everyone is cured sooner or later. In the end, they will shoot you. I'll see you again. Oh, and I hope the rats won't bother you. Most of them are very well fed. The ones that aren't, well, you can make pets of them.
No, please! Oh, my, please, no!
Freedom is slavery. Your brother is power. 2 + 2 = 5. How long have I been here? How long? They've been good to me lately. They even give me food. Nice food. Food from Big Brother. When will they shoot me? Jones, Aronson, and Rutherford were guilty of the crimes they were charged with. Of course. I made all the other up. When will Big Brother shoot me? When? Soon to another house. I hope so. I want him to shoot me. I wonder why I ever rebelled. It's all so easy if you try. O'Brien says he can float on the floor like a soap. And I can make myself see him do it. And then he does it. All the happenings are in the mind. Whatever happens in all minds truly happens. Yes. I have a five-finger hand. How much longer before they shoot me? 5 days? They always shoot you in the back of the neck when you're walking down a corridor. I'll know when it's coming. And the second before it happens, I won't shake a muscle in my face. I'll think like, feel like, dream right up to that very moment. Then I'll hate them while the bullet is on the way to my brain. When it is too late to call it back! Oh, how long? How long?
Julia! Julia! Open me! Julia!
You've had thoughts of deceiving me. Look at me, Winston. You are improving. Intellectually, there is very little wrong with you. It is only emotionally that you fail. Now, tell me, what are your honest feelings toward Big Brother?
I hate him!
Good. Then the time has come for you to learn acceptance. You must love Big Brother. You know what is in room 101, Winston. 'Tis the truth. But the truth varies from person to person. For some it may be burial alive, or death by fire, or drowning. It may be something not even fatal. In your case, Winston, the truth happens to be rats.
You can't do that! You couldn't! You couldn't!
Learning and understanding are not always enough. There must also be acceptance of the truth. The time has come for you to learn acceptance.
O'Brien, you know this is not necessary! Just tell me what it is you want me to do, I'll do it!
The rat is carnivorous. Sometimes he eats the nose. Sometimes he burrows through the cheek to get to the tongue.
But what is it? How can I do it if I don't know what it is you want me to do?
To release the rat, I just have to raise the lid. He will come leaping out because he is hungry. When do you suppose he'll open your eyes?
O'Brien! Do it to Julia! Do it to Julia, not to me! I don't care what you do to her! Tear her face off, strip her to the bones! Not to me! To Julia! I love Big Brother! I love him!
Welcome, Winston. Welcome back into the party.
Barbaric hordes, only one army of Oceania is there to defend it.
Hello, Falcon.
Hello, Winter.
Ready for our game?
Let me have some victory coffee first. I need some. What do you think of the news, Winston?
I'm worried. Quite worried. Take a look at this map. See it for yourself.
White moon.
Yes. Yes, I. What do you think of the news, son?
Bad. Very bad. How do you like your new job?
Good. Very fun job. I make a great deal of money, and the hours, very good. Sometimes I don't have to go to work at all.
What is the job, Winston?
I'm a part of a committee, a subcommittee, that is. We discuss things and we talk about them. We are working on some sort of report, right? Very bad. All of that.
Have another coffee.
Yes. Pardon me, son. Hello, Julia. It's me, Winston.
I know.
It's been a while since I've seen you.
I've noticed you before. I come here often only I sit at a back table. Today I wanted to be near the telescreen. I'm worried about Africa.
I know. It's bad. Julia.
I betrayed you.
I betrayed you too.
Sometimes they threaten you with something. Something you can't stand up to, can't even think about.
Yes, they do that.
And you say don't do it to me. Do it to
her.
Afterward, you might pretend it was a trick to fool them. But that isn't true. At the time when it happens, you do mean it. You think there's no other way of saving yourself, and you want it to happen to the other person. You don't care what they suffer. All you think about is yourself.
All you think about is yourself.
And afterward, you don't feel the same toward the other person any longer.
No, you don't feel the same.
I must go.
We must meet again, Julia.
Yes, we must meet again.
Comrades, everyone stand by for a vital announcement. All comrades stand by.
Goodbye, Julia. Oh, Bat. Bat! Why, if we lose the Congo, all of Africa will go.
There'll be no stopping it. If we lose the Congo, why, Oceania itself will be threatened. Don't you realize that London itself might fall? Why won't we bother do something? Anything! Anything!
We'll all have to work a little harder for victory. We can't recapture the Congo.
Don't you realize we could lose the war?
Comrades, the brother himself is at the front and has taken personal control of all military operations. By a vast strategic maneuver, Big Brother has led our glorious forces to victory. Big Brother has brought the war within measurable distance of its end.
Victory.
This is the greatest victory in human history. Big Brother is still at the front.
Victory! Victory, did you hear that? I can't believe it! Big Brother saved Africa! He saved us all! I never noticed it before. But Big Brother has a warm, tender smile. Big Brother!